point.
Yeah, you're wondering, what the hell are we measuring here exactly? I think that's it.
Yeah.
So that's the essentially the cut. It goes 25 feet down. Oh, you know, we gotta get parallel too. We want to get down to 8 inches, and we want to cut it all in half.
Yeah.
Right? And we want to do that with equal sections, right?
Yeah.
So, cast halfway around the pipe.
Yeah.
Yeah, see?
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Oh, so if we went one more cut, we would have to, this doesn't work.
That's right.
All right. We'd have to go back to using division.
Because you also got to account for the thickness of the paper being folded too, and blah, 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 blah.
Well, yeah, like you said.
I can goof that.
You can goof it.
There it goes. Find one right here and here, and I can just go off of that.
All right. You know what? That's not actually the mark. Single point down there. Halfway between these two marks.
I worked at a job once where they wanted everything within a 32nd of an inch, and you had to use a scribe for everything. Oh, it sucked.
Okay, this isn't that job. And it's a good thing, because that's off my 8th inch right there. Isabel, I love you too, I do. You bet I do, that's right. All right, thank you. Okay. There you go. Just make it 6 feet.
Sure, yeah.
And then we'll taper the next one into it, right?
Yep.
That's not right.
Okay, go ahead.
That's right?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Is that good enough?
Yeah, that's good enough. Just 2 tacks here and a little
rough. Oh,
here.
You know what we didn't do?
What?
We didn't account for the curve of the torch.
Oh, shit. You're
oh,
right.
Shit.
Yeah, we're going to have to put spacers. It's just going like this right here.
Yeah. That'll do. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I didn't see that move at all.
Yeah, I didn't either. That's perfect.
We could have. We could break this apart and run it out.
But then we'd have to break all these off.
Yeah. Well, man, that is an amazing amount of bow. Yeah, that'll stay up there.
Oh, I can feel it cooling down already.
We need a stencil director across that.
I can touch a spot real quick with the grinder. That's okay, now we can grind it.
Little grind it. Okay. Now don't let us go too far.
Oh, too much. Back, stop.
Oh, it's just gonna roll.
Damn it. Damn it to hell, man.
Wait, what if we roll it and he chucks a...
What if we'll put Bart's finger in the roller?
No, we'll roll it and he can just take a piece of steel and wedge it on the roller.
On the wheel.
I can do that. I can put my finger in there.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Go down, lift
it up.
You're gonna go down. You're gonna put your finger in there?
No, he's gonna lift it up.
Well, I can spin it, and he can look at it. It doesn't matter to me.
He wants to go back that way. That should be level, right?
That's pretty much straight up and down right there.
All right, it's wedged. We're good.
Now instead of cutting the next one over, we decided to skip a couple and go to this one. We think that it'll
relieve some of the stresses around the pipe more evenly.
Here's a happy hot dog in there. Yeah, you're hot. Yes, you are. Oh, I love you too.
And the ladies have finished our dragons today. Well, they said they're finished. Now she's spraying again. But this sunlight's going to do these justice. But they are kind of this, came out with a nice fade in there of glitter. Yeah, they look fantastic. Thank you, guys.
Hey, no, Doug, thank you.
Oh, yes, right. Working at 83.
Would you like to see my good eye or my bad eye?
Oh, yeah, and Betsy's got her cataract removed. And she's going to have 20/20 in one eyeball at least. That's good.
That's that one.
That's that one?
Yeah, the other one is still. Can't see shit.
Make his nails pop.
Right. Manicured bush.
Manicured look.
Bark. Hope he gets shiny.
There.
That's beautiful. Know if you see a tornado on the screen?
I don't know, I may take a nap.
All right. All right, we got Bill here now. Welcome to the crew. And hey. Drew, who has been diligently grinding on this beast for the last 2 days. And so all the edges are ready to come together. So the next step to do is to cut out all the little tabs. And well, I guess we need to make those things go in the center. To.
I still got to get the cutting wheel and grind down there.
Yeah, Alan, we need to attach it to the other section.
Yeah.
So that we can roll it without these things just flopping around in the wind.
Ooh, so close. There it goes.
That's
good. Nice.
Now, we think it's already right up and down, right?
It was, yes, yeah.
We ought to check that again, because we do that with a crane, right?
Yes.
All right.
That way, but it's got to go that way, like a half inch on my end. Okay.
Jones are using the laser in the end of a level to shoot down, and then he can see how that end of that pipe needs to move. And we're just going to get some temporary tacks on it, and then we can roll the whole pipe using this weight to ride on the rollers and just to suspend the part we're gonna taper out there. At least that's the plan. shit. That came down tons. All right, is flexing that much? Huh. And maybe it's just flexing that much. It also went off to the side, though, too.
It did. Yeah.
All right, let's just go back up on it and see if we can't correct it for that side at least, and then we'll try again.
I mean, this one's high. This one's low. This one's...
So you think it's just the distortion of the pipe?
Just stretching back out.
Yeah, it could be. Let me look at it from the other side. A lot of flex time. I mean, just the whole thing.
But you're also moving the whole...
I'm moving the whole pipe.
Yeah.
Well...
Yeah.
More so at this end, though.
Right, from midpoint. Too.
Let me see what the joint's doing. Somebody wiggle it. Sure. Let's see what the joint's doing. Well, there's nothing noticeably moving.
You want me to take tension off the crane? See how much it moves?
Yeah, go ahead. Lower it back down again. Just seeing normal sag.
Yeah, because...
Let's go ahead and unchain it and roll it over and see what it looks like then.
It's up to almost 5 inches, 4 3/4.
Going back down.
Going back down, it's about 4 1/4, so it dropped a half.
Alright, one way or the other.
Yep. And the shocks just probably popped it.
Down to release. Rolling it around like that.
Flipping back over to dual shield wire today. This is dual shield, is just one brand name. I think it's Outer Shield and another brand.
It had his thumb. Like great big old slice in his thumb. Right? You know, just great. Like...
Man, I could be thinking about a ton of things, but when my hands are near that blade, I'm only thinking about that blade.
I hate
the environment for sure.
Yeah, it is.
Start walking toward the inside, not the outside. Look around and see how that goes in there. We kind of need something underneath it already to start pulling up.
Like yeah,
a strap.
We're gonna have, you're right, you're going to have to lift the whole thing up, but I don't. But right here, or about
You've
right
got
here.
So much droop.
Yes.
Now that you guys got your fingers out,
you don't have gloves on, man.
Yeah, you need.
Yeah, safety third.
Safety third. Okay, I want to put my foot in here. You pull that back. Uh-huh. We're gonna get this one up on top.
Sure.
Look at that.
I know. It's just all just gonna.
Yeah, I'll let you do that.
Now you want another one of those?
Yeah, I think we're gonna have to have one
go
back
here.
Here and
look at that.
Ah, goody goody.
And I got a little baby.
Okay. So, see, yeah, cool.
wrap this one over.
I'm almost to the point where we're just going to have to put a few tacks in, hold shit where we want it.
Probably right.
And if we have to cut them, we have to cut them.
If it's, yeah.
We could do it this way, but Jesus, it's just going
to
get.
It's proven to be pretty difficult.
Yeah. I think a tack here and there will help us. Good lesson for a welder. It's not really the welding, it's the fitting.
Yeah.
That's where the. Yeah. You get that part right, the rest of it is just. Sitting there running a beat thinking about girlfriend, buddy.
All right, this is hard to see on camera, but you're actually looking back through multiple holes and multiple of those pieces. We got, what, three of them in right now?
Yeah.
And so we can look through those holes and we can see by the light as to whether this thing is bending down or up. So go ahead and lower that crane and let's see what it does right there. Yeah, see, that's right there. It can go up a bit. Yeah, see, you can see how it's working there. So we just got to line these holes up. And we've got a fairly straight mast. And we only need a fairly straight. We don't have to mimic like Douglas fir, you know? We don't have to be any better than that. You can't grow trees very straight. This from the other end. And oh man, it's hard to see. Oh no. Okay. Hey, maybe we need to see it better. Yeah, move it. Yeah, there it goes.
Lower. Hurry up there. Okay, lower.
Round guys have served us well, and that one up there has gotten it to where it's circular, but we need it out of the way so we can close these together more, and we decided to get rid of it completely because we think it's done its job. It was either that or leave it in there permanently, and we decided, no, not permanently.
Is it the right one? No.
No, you've got another one.
I got another one in there.
Yeah, you got
one. There you go. That's it.
Two and a half.
Two and a half. Okay. Yeah. 4 7/8. All right. Somebody
pretty
do the math.
Five. Yeah, pretty much five.
Now we move this to the bottom side.
Yeah.
And do it again.
Mm-hmm.
Up. Stop.
4 1/2.
4 1/2.
That's what it was supposed to be, wasn't it?
4 7/8 was the other one.
Yeah. Yep.
So it's sagging.
So it's going. So it's this is 4 1/2. It's 4 7/8. So it's going sagging.
Maybe it's because it's like
no.
Maybe it's because the weight of it, and all we got is two pieces that lifted up in the air down there. It's how much did you see? That's 3/8 of an inch off.
3/8 of an inch.
Fuck!
In 6 feet.
I don't give a shit about 3/8 of an inch.
In 6 feet.
Yeah. So if we had 3/8 of an inch in the next one, we'd be at we're still in the inch and a half margin of error. But the other thing we didn't do is side to side, and it took me off there too. Man, it looks good.
Go up a little.
Up.
This is the same. 3 5/8.
Oh, good.
So it's just.
Damn.
3 5/8 is how. What was this?
It was 3 5/8.
Wow, it's.
It's perfect. It's dead on.
Spot on.
And that's why it's sagging, and that's why it's throwing us off up and down. So, once
it's,
again.
It's just flexing a little bit. 3/8 is nothing.
Yeah.
It's nothing.
I'm with you.
We're
you
good.
Rotated it, yeah,
I want to get
it.
The,
see?
Yo necesito aprender español. Ustedes son mi profesor.
Is he cussing at you?
Yeah.
No, I'm not. I know how to do cussing already. I'm not gonna do it. Double up.
Oh,
whoa. Watch it.
All right.
Yeah.
All right.
He signed that waiver, didn't he?
Yeah, we got to wait for it. Well, slowly but surely we're putting tacks in and it's coming along nicely. We're just in the shade taking a break right now.
That's 90.
I sold it.
For himself.
We don't negotiate with labor.
Part two.
On Saturdays.
Yeah.
Wow, Jim, is that a thermal mug? Let me see the other side. Oh, that's nice. What does it say on the other side? Doug autographed it, the grinder god. Wow, I'll bet he'd do that for anybody that bought one. Don't you think so?
Oh,
geez. And it keeps the drinks nice and cold, even on these hot days.
Honey, that's empty. Would you mind filling it up?
No, damn it.
Well, there it is, all tacked together, and I am very happy with that. It's got, they went back and took a few of the bulges out of it, and anything that's left in it, I think it gives character. And we're about 9 inches here at the end, and it's about 16 at the other end. A little old out here, but we can, I don't know, probably not going to do anything about that. We're going to put some sort of a cap or plug in it, some sort of a vent in it, and then have to figure out the hardware up here to hang sails from. See a bow in it?
Just a little bit at 9 o'clock. It bows, the top is to the right of center, it looks like.
Yeah, when it comes out this way?
Right.
It's coming sideways a little bit.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, so there's a tree. Welding along this side first.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that'll pull the bowl out. Pull the bowl out.
A little bit. Yeah. And we got to give a big thank you to Keith over at Turn Right Machine Works, because this is the guy that showed us the video about that you could even taper a pipe like this. Now, did we do as good a job as Keith? Fuck no, we didn't do as good a job as Keith. But did we get the job done? We did. And that's right. Keith says, you know, get her done.
We're going to have to go around the house.
Yep. Yeah, we'll put like a half gallon on it. Okay. The crack that's between the two.
Yeah, and then there's...
And then that's how I'm going to glue it to the boat, too, is I'm just going to run a bead along here. Oh, that's better. You can really see the difference in the materials. This is syntactic foam. We had a bunch left of it, so we just poured this one with syntactic foam. This one we fiberglassed, so it's a much thinner shell. This is probably stronger, but it's heavier too. So we'll just cut the split difference. Look at that. A cobweb and a wasp nest. It looks like they've already hatched out this year. They're gone. It really shows how good that material is we're using. This is mainly styro spray and spar varnish. That's a polyurethane.
Green tail, green dragon, green light, green sock.
Cool. Yeah, that's not right.
Okay, it's got a high spot there.
Yeah, we just reduced the one over on this side, a high spot.
Yeah. Then I wonder about the overall straight. Can we look down and see a bail?
Let's try that.
Bolt it up. As far as the bumps in it, nah, that's... Y'all go look at that mast. And that's professionally made, rolled over there on an anvil.
I mean, I can see it's wavy already right here.
Yeah, it's wavy.
Yeah, I was looking down the side.
It's not as wavy as ours, but it's still...
Yeah, this was done on a machine.
This is good as they
get. We are the machine.
Yeah.
As you look at the end of it.
We're doing it. And then you're going to hang sails all over it, and it'll be crap. You never see it.
You block and tackle. It'll be a perch to stand on, like a crow's nest.
Yeah. All right. Yeah, we could mess with it more, but let's just get the back gougers out and spend some time in there. Back gouging the snot out of it.
Okay.
Where'd my partly cloudy go to?
The ladder after lunch, and the ground had thawed a little bit, and the ladder sunk into the ground, and he came down, got injured, sued Warner Ladder for $2 million.
Because the ground thawed?
Because the ground thawed. And he won the case. He went to court with it and won the case, yeah? Because the judge says, you didn't warn him against it.
you know, what are you going to warn against, you know, everything?
Yeah, I know.
So now you buy a Warner ladder that was $100, it's $300.
Yeah.
And it's got labels from one end to the other.
Yeah.
Warning you against
all kinds of stupid things.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean,
And the meaningful ones are lost amongst all the noise. You know? Some new material they call wood. I want to go out used up, worn out, broken down.
Used up, yeah.
Follow the 74 degrees.
Yeah.
These actually did pretty good, 300 pound loads, and they've had 3,000 pounds on them.
That right there looks like a bend to me.
Okay.
Let's go 2 lengths.
Whoa!
Get that place as length you want, 3 inches off. That's the lowest spot right there.
Was where the original oriented.
Yeah, so we're seeing the same thing. So we need to cut this one back, this one back. I'm not sure that's worth the work.
We could try it. It'd be kind of an interesting thing to see if we can fix that. See, here's the deal. See this piece of steel and that?
Right.
They're the same pipe, so they used to be the same length, and now this is 16th inch closer back in, and this one down here is too. So that one's a little bit off right there.
Well, somewhere it's because you didn't.
So it's almost like we'd have
to. The gaps are not right, right? In certain places.
Yeah, this is an 8 and this is a 16. Oh, wow. So.
Yeah, so we think if we cut the big one here and here, we take this half up and bring this half up to meet it, which may mean cutting some tacks on this too.
Can you come back here and measure the height and roll it and see kind of where this really goes? Long?
Yeah.
That's not bad.
Yeah, we could.
If you come in here and put the flat thing and put your right angle duber over it and roll it.
Yeah.
You can get a good.
We can see how far back it starts.
Yeah, and maybe it's, you know.
Yeah,
at
let's
least
do that.
Get an idea. The flashlights, Jack.
Yeah, 5/8.
I think I'll miss. Which way are you going?
Whoops, sorry.
You gotta go back.
Okay.
There you go.
Like a quarter inch. Here.
Okay, well, if you were just off a half an inch, you'd be okay with that.
If I'm off, and I'm okay with what we're off now.
Because okay. I don't think you go back any further than that.
I'm bald.
Yeah, what are all these numbers over here? What do they mean?
I have no idea, man. But maybe that's base 12.
Yeah, that's that new mass.
If we're looking at anything structural, I think we're looking at something that may be aesthetic. Mm-hmm. And I think with all the other crap that hangs off boats, I don't think you gotta worry about it.
And you know, 64,000 people are gonna tell you otherwise, but you're good with this.
I'm good
now,
with this.
There
yeah.
we go.
This is only the first
if you don't have confidence in yourself, you have no business yeah. making YouTube videos.
You know, that's when you bought the shirt.
Yeah.
Have lines coming down straight down the mast. Those would show it. Yeah. But they kind of come off at angles too. So I think you'll see it. I'm just not sure I care. If we're gonna do it, we just do those two cuts and then see what happens.
And try and pull them a little bit.
I don't think that much is gonna. You're gonna make up that much in welding.
I don't think so.
I think you, if you do anything, you're gonna have to cut those seams. Just barely enough room.
Yeah.
You're clicking wheels, but.
Yeah.
You know, just
you don't do that in open wheel. You're not supposed to.
Well, in carts you can a little bit, but you can still get in big trouble.
Yeah, you get big trouble.
Yeah, and then.
We all know what happened last time I got up there drilling.
We, not all of us know.
Oh, he fell off. You didn't see that?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. The dummy fell off. I mean,
yeah, the dummy.
Wow, really? He says it with love, Jack.
Yes.
Well, I did too, Jack.
And I was being literal.
Yeah.
Well, the dummy.
The dummy did fall off.
Bring the bottom up now and weld a few places here.
Yeah.
It would hold it in alignment.
So what we've done is we've split it down the sides and put a beam across down there and hooked our cable from our crane onto it there. And so now we can raise this side of it. We're gonna see if we can raise this along with it until we get these matched up and some of our bow taken out.
Working great. Bill? It's gonna work.
Yeah, I see.
Okay, that looks like it's pretty much touching now.
Okay, yeah.
I thought you were getting ready to yell at me.
Wow, that came up a lot. So we bring the bottom up to meet it, then every once in a while we can set it down and roll it. Yep. Check it. So we brought it up 1 3/8. I'm gonna bring it up another 1 1/4. Okay, step back a little bit, guys. I don't want to knock your nuts off. That's another 1 3/8. They moved, didn't they?
They did move.
You involve somebody's family jewels and they get it the fuck out of the way. Yeah, that's the way it works.
Listen, I've got compromise in my family's jewels.
Yeah, all right, let's eat lunch. Yeah.
Well, it's too late now because we mounted it flush.
Oh, okay. We'll make it work. Okay. It's just beautiful.
Oh, just a little more, Bill.
Oh.
Ooh. Perfect. Right there is like good. You want me to tack that?
No, I should just stay.
Right, little.
No.
Can't see it's pinching it now. Yeah, it's got one spot. It's too much here.
Yeah, we can pull that in though.
Yeah, so just where it's good, put a tack.
Right there.
Okay.
Just back to.
We're 2 inches out.
Yeah.
Yeah, so we're doing better.
Yeah.
Called a dual shield wire, or there's another name for it by another company. But it has a flux on it, and that comes off. But it also has a cover gas on it, too. So you have to have CO2 gas and this. and that it's supposed to be a little bit more flexible of a weld.
We're at 19 and looks to be
just round it off
a touch under. It's between like a quarter and a half.
That's called 3/8.
Well, like not quite 3/8, just a touch under 3/8. It's like
okay.
Right above.
All right, 5/16.
It doesn't look bad right there as far as
plain. Well, it's an inch and 3/4 out, which really ain't that much.
What about that basket you made for transporting lead?
That's oh, we can put lead in it, yeah.
Yeah.
You can get their eyes in. The moss isn't growing yet. Wanted to bring that end up. We needed it. It was 3 inches out when we started,
yeah.
And now we're a half inch out, so we're making good progress on it.
Where we are right here is 19 inches, and if I go 90, or I go 180,
180, yeah.
It's 18 3/4, I think it was.
Oh, well, that's only a quarter inch out then. I ain't gonna help you move it. I trust you. I can tell by just watching that.
18 3/8.
18 3/8, so less than a quarter inch
less
out.
Less than a quarter of an inch.
Yeah, so
damn.
That is the way to straighten it. Is and what we did is we needed to come up like 3 inches, so we pulled more than 3 inches, and then we needed to come up 2 inches, so we pulled more than 2 inches, like we pulled three another inch, and that seems to be this trick. And it was definitely, you know, going too hard, and then we started welding. So now the trick is now we got it actually straight. Is to go around it and make the welds real evenly around it, let it cool down, and then keep watching it to make sure that we don't jack it up and take it out of this. And we can keep, you know, just where you put the welds is where the side that it shrinks, so it, you know, it'll make the bow up for if you're welding on the top. So it's kind of cool, so we can roll it around and always weld on the top, which makes the welding a lot easier.
Right on top of the
finger.
And I